So, hi everyone. I want to step away for a second from doing reviews and just sharing stuff with you guys. And as the title states, I've been thinking a lot about this lately in terms of are we too trusting when we use, social media and online? And I've seen a lot of stuff going on lately that's been kind of interesting. I've come across a couple of like false posts on Instagram and other, probably even other social media sites as well, but I noticed it on Instagram recently that one of the major shoe tennis shoe companies was having a recruitment, and somebody I had been tagged by like 15 different people to see if I wanted to try out that or I wanted to participate in that particular recruitment. And when I saw the post, I thought it looked a little odd. And I do know that the major shoe company does have like a recruitment program where they try to find people to test their shoes for a set amount of time and things like that. Well, somebody finally called, I guess, the major company's attention and that they did prove that it was fake. So that was one thing. And I think we all come across people that have been scammed online, be it from giveaways that weren't or, financial help that they're hoping to get and they don't. I also have someone that is kind of my Instagram friend, and she had that happen. She had been following one of those pages that I guess that would help you if you had financial issues, and apparently I guess she lost money in that. So I was just thinking about that, and then I was thinking about a lot of other things that have been happening within the last week or so. And I've been having a lot of people, again, via Instagram mainly, want to be friends in terms of like direct messaging and stuff like that. And that's another thing that I think everybody's been experiencing lately, because some of the things these people, and I use the term loosely people, because I don't know if the actual person is a man or a woman, are just funny. I've had a lot of interesting things, but I will say that you can kind of pick out a pattern with these, if you want to call them scammers, if you want to call them, they have a lot of different names. But we'll just say, as an example, possible scammer. You find a pattern in the dialogue for the most part. And I've had three major things that I've noticed usually, which are the main ones. I've noticed that I've had people that are profiles that portray themselves to be men most of the time, or well, all the time for the most part. And I've also had a couple of ones where the guy's portrayed or the person portrays himself as being somebody that's in the military. I've also had the widower story that the person's wife passed away and they're raising a child or they have a child of a set age. And I've also had the divorcee that's lonely and needs a friend. Or the last one, which is usually the least, the single person that wants to be a friend. So it's kind of interesting when you go through that dynamic and you start to pick out the variations in the stories, like especially the widowers. The widowers usually, I've noticed that the story is usually the wife died within the last 3 years and they have at least one child of a set age. And then I have, of course, the people that are, I'm in the military and I'm abroad and, I'm from this state. Where do you live? And that's usually when I'm like, no. And sometimes it's just kind of funny because sometimes it's just random, like hellos, and then, you get into the like, I'll reply hello, and then suddenly it's, three questions later, and it's like, are you married? Do you have children? Are you looking for a relationship? I actually had one person ask me if I lived alone, and I've mentioned that I think I mentioned that in a previous video. But it just kind of makes me laugh because you really think how many people say yes to something and they don't think about it, and then you're like, uh-oh, what did I do? But again, I think if it's, why would you need to meet someone via Instagram? I could see if you're friends or if you develop a relationship with a person in terms of relationship being a friend or somebody that lives in your area and you'd like to meet them. That's a different story. But getting back to these random messages, or I like to call them let's be friends, because sometimes that's what most of the employees are. They're like, oh, I just want somebody to chat with and I'd like to be friends. Well, it's kind of funny because I had one person try to psychoanalyze me one day and I was like, what on earth is this? I had another person get upset because I didn't want to tell them if I was married or not. And I'm like, what business is it of these people? And I also had somebody call me a man. I'm like, yeah, I have nothing better to do than portray myself online as a woman, and I'm a man, and I have no life. And it's just kind of interesting, some of the things, but again, you kind of notice or you pick up a pattern in these dialogues because you either notice that there's spelling errors or the per there or the auto translate if their person's in another country doesn't translate correctly. Or you also just kind of get a feel of the, again, the dialogue, and you know something's not quite right. But it's always interesting when somebody tells you that you're beautiful within the first, 3 minutes of interaction, and then they tell you that they'll cross the ocean for you or something. I, for that particular one, I was about ready to pee in my pants. It was hilarious. I actually took screenshots and I sent them to a friend of mine, and they were just dying of laughter. And they wanted, and I told them, I go, can they pick out the cheesiest lines ever? Because it was something silly, like, God'll, it was something silly, like, I'll cross the ocean for you, or, I'll walk 1,000 miles on a mountain for you. Something crazy that reminded me of, like, song lyrics. And I couldn't stop laughing. It was very funny. I actually had an Instagram friend of mine tell me that somebody had asked to, that they, excuse me, that they had someone ask if they could adopt them so they could come and live with them. And I couldn't stop laughing, and I asked her if it was if she was serious, and she said yes. She goes, the person sent a message asking if they would adopt them. And I thought that was just some of the things people come up with are just really funny. So I just figured that I'd have this little chat with you guys, which probably sounded more like a ramble, but somebody might find this entertaining, and open that dialogue and see what you guys have to think about the topic, and just see if anybody else has noticed or thinks that we're becoming a little too trusting online or using social media. And if anybody has any good stories, excuse me, if anybody has any really good stories about direct messages, let me know, because I'd love to hear them, because some of them are just, it's just funny. Because you know that they find like the cheesiest lines ever and copy and paste them into the chat, hoping somebody will fall in love with them. But anyways, have a good rest of your day, everybody, and bye. See you guys next time.